Hey guys, so today's video is going to be a little bit different. We're going to take a look in my new little book. It's the Pocket Scavenger. You've seen it before and I was just not done with it. So now that I did most of it complete, there's like maybe very few that I left blank because I couldn't find some of the things, but we're going to take a look and see how many I was able to find. So this is my pocket scavenger hunt. It's the pocket scavenger, but this is how I decorated the actual book. This is fabric, what's it called? Fabric glue, something like that. And I just kind of put something over it. Here is where I would be writing kind of like the year or something about it. I didn't decide yet, but I covered Keri Smith's name. This is the person that came up with the idea for the book. And then I put little pearls and diamonds everywhere. And then I have it tied up right now with a ribbon. And I didn't decorate the back. So let's open that up. And we're going to get to, I think the very front page has my personal information, which is why I have this page folded down onto it. And this is the actual scavenger checklist. So we're going to go through it. Let's flip past these pages here. These ones are like just instructional ones. Let me go to the main page. And again, see they tell you that this is how you can keep your book safe. And yeah. I didn't do the legend part yet. I didn't know exactly. It says draw a detailed map of your neighborhood and everything. But I didn't have a chance to do that because I moved again, so I'm pretty sure I'll do that pretty soon. And this is the first one, so it says postage stamps, and this is the ones I collected so far. There's more in my other book, the Destroy the Journal book. These ones are the ones left over, and I collected them over time from my previous office. And then number 5, I think I just get random tags, and this one was $5.99. And I have stickers, so I was going to put more number 5s in there. This is random paper clips. I want to fill the whole page with paper clips. This ones are feathers. It's like, find a feather. And I have feathers because we have a down pillow that has feathers. And then this one, recently I just got an envelope from my old work, so I attached it here, but it had my personal information on it, so I cut it in half. Then it says a ticket, and again, I found it randomly. There's different tickets here. Parking ticket. This is a bus, an old bus ticket. Now it changed to this one. And then now, recently, be this compass one. They named it the compass because it can be used for buses and sky trains. So, and then there's a movie ticket. And another ticket that I don't remember what it's from. So, anyways. These ones are the tickets for now. Then it says 9 circles, and these ones are all the only circles. 3, 6, 7, 8, yeah. And this one's a circle here. Some random key. I don't know whose key that is. This is a random form of currency, and in this one we have a Canadian Tire. And I also have $1 bills somehow. I don't know how I got this money, where it's from. So yeah, American money. Right there, just randomly. I'll leave it in here for now. I might use it. Something you can see through, which is kind of like a plastic thing, but I was gonna put something inside of it, so I'm not done with this page yet. And then different textures, and then again I put these randomly. This is fabric, bubble wrap. This is a different type of fabric. It's for the inside lining of like high heels, I guess. When you wear heels or something, then this one kind of makes it very soft. And then this one is like just ribbon, kind of, not sure what it is. Oh, and then this one is a different kind of feel, but it is glittery and nice. So yeah, different types of textures. Then something with text on it, and again a movie ticket. I recently went to see Ready Player One, I seen it on the 30th of March. And some other texts and receipts. Alright, and a post-it note, and I didn't want to write anything yet here because I was going to fill it with different types of post-it notes because I have so many shapes and different things. So, post-it note, moss. I don't have moss yet. Some wire, and it can be like any wire. I don't know why I posted this one. This is more wire-like. But I'm going to, I think I have another actual wire. I just can't find it yet. Part of something you ate. This one came with the noodles. These ones are some kind of like crackers or something that came in the noodle box. This is some dried fruit. That's strawberry. This is banana. And this is a packet of Tim Hortons sugar. So, I mean, I had tea and usually I take extra sugar with me. What else? Something you can only find in your local environment. And this one, I wasn't really sure what they meant by that. So I kind of put the McDonald's thing because they collect little stickers. And when you have your seventh one, you get a free coffee. And that was local. And this is also local. It's a ordering takeout food. Something on your body. So this one is actually real. I did have eyelashes, but then I lost one. So I just kept this one here, and the glue from the eyelashes staying on. Lipstick, nail polish. You can have on your body a hair clip. You can have on your body a band-aid. Fake tattoos. All this makeup in the background, if you can see it, to like cover up. Eyeliner or mascara and so on. And again, another fake tattoo. That's all I could really find. I don't know about this, but I just kind of put it there. So yeah, I used tea bag. I didn't actually use up the tea bag. I just wanted to keep these ones here because these ones are some of my favorite teas, and I'm going to be putting more on there. So I'm not done with this page. I'm going to put them on here on this side too. It's going to get really big. I don't have a napkin yet. At least I couldn't find one. Something sticky. And again, this is a double-sided tape. I didn't want to take it off. This is also a sticker, and this is one of the things that you used to put on the little floppy disks, so that's sticky, and then this is tape, which is also sticky. In my opinion, that's what I think anyways. This is six blue things. And then so here we have a nail file, paper clips, a rubber band, a heart-shaped sticker, maybe like ribbon. And this was from like a baby shower, so I kind of added this here. And then this one is one of those little packet things, like don't eat, forgot what it's called anyways. And then this is a body sticker, what's it called, fake tattoo, and also food stamp. Yes, food stamp. And then blue nail polish here as well. So I kind of just made this page a little bit more blue. A piece of a puzzle I don't have yet, an elastic band, and here's a couple, an image of a character, and of course I have SpongeBob. And then I was gonna fill this whole page with SpongeBob, but I think I'm gonna add random characters in here, so we'll see. I also like how they have like a picture of Yoda right here. It's like poorly drawn Yoda. several kinds of leaves, and then here's a real leaf changing color, foliage. I kind of like that one that I found, this one, and then this one, but I'm going to be adding more leaves. I might just do that. So I didn't write the date on there. I might just fill up the page with leaves, a red piece of string, and a wrapper, couple wrappers anyways. Let me just see here. A photo of yourself. That's me when I had most of my hair blonde. And then, which one is this? A postcard? This is a postcard that I got from a restaurant. It came with the bill, and then you just kind of have a free postcard. And this one's, the restaurant's name is Lolita's. So it actually was really nice. four squares. And I'm going to find something more squares. Anyways, these ones are stickers that I had. And then 5 buttons. This is one that came with something. So I'm going to be adding a couple more. An image of an elephant. And this is the stickers that I had so far. Maybe I'll draw an elephant. I didn't have the time at the time. Rock tracings I don't have yet. Something orange. So then I have a packet of hot sauce, which says you had me a taco. coupons that are orange. Special tag that is orange. Stickers. And a Q-tip. And a sticky note, sort of. But most likely it's more like the stickers. I don't know. I'll find other orangey things. This is also another sticky note. So that one was orange. What else? Ooh, this is heavy. This one here is something from the year you were born. And that's my date of birth, my brother, the year I graduated. And I just kind of put different coins on there. A handwritten quote. I don't have one yet. I didn't think of one yet. And there are samples of different handwriting. So I have one sample here for my appointment. There was another one here from someone else. And another one here. I don't know where this is anyways. So I didn't go there. A pencil rubbing over gravestone. Okay, I'll have to find a gravestone. I really don't have one anywhere nearby. I don't have a hair sample yet. Creepy. And I have lots of fortune cookies. So, fortunes, lots of fortunes. Most of them came true, if anything. life will shower you happiness. Happiness on you, upon you. Yeah. Interesting, just interesting stuff. You will meet with much success. It's all like almost about success. I don't know, it's just weird. Okay, and then a coupon. So there's a couple coupons. These ones usually from Value Village because I go there often with my mom. And yeah, I go there quite often. So when you return, well, same with this one, you get a discount. If you have one of these and you return clothes, they give you 5% off. Let's see here. Something that is broken or damaged. Oh, I don't have one yet. I don't know. I can't find one yet. Anyways, something that was discarded. This one was a little band thingy. This one was a tag from my Ted plushie. This one was a Armin van Buuren concert ticket. And this is another one, Easy Park. Just a ticket, I guess. I don't know, I can't find anything else that might be discarded. Something that is green. And this here, just recently I put this because it's actually the, what's it called? Oh, there was this candy that I'm going to be showing you pretty soon, but this is paint. So I'm just going to put paint there. I don't have anything else that's green. Green stain. I don't know. Something that can be crumbled, and this is again a wrapper. It's a pretty nice wrapper. It has hearts on it. And then a receipt. And then maybe something like this. I don't know what else to add there. Mm-hmm. Okay, oop. We're getting on there. Alright, so the next thing is something that can be dragged or leaves a mark. And this is the only thing I really came up with. I don't know where I found this, but it's a metal piece. I'll need to find more. Okay, something that was part of a tree, which is popsicle sticks. Something that was planted. So here we have part of a flower, sort of petals, and another nice leaf. Oh, Okay, let me skip that one anyways. A piece of flat candy. So here we have, it was flattened anyway because it was too big, but this was one of the lifesavers. Then there is some kind of sticky thing underneath here, and that's why I put the paper covering. And then I remember that I have a piece of gum, kind of like this kind anyway, so that is flat. Something left by an animal. I don't have an animal, so I don't know. Something that was created using a machine. Kind of like a sticker or like a business card. Something. This is from Montreal on a price tag. So yeah. Something that was made by hand. I think ribbons were made by hand. So I added a ribbon here, but I also put here nail gems because they look poorly done anyways. The glue is already added here. You just have to peel it off and put it on your nails. But that is the closest that I could get. I can't find anything else. A piece of origami, I don't know. I can't think of one yet. Something that was given to you. This was a flower, part of a bouquet. So it was cute little flowers. Yeah. Okay, this one is a drawing not done by you. And I found this from a book that I found at Value Village. It was this one, and then it was another page. So I took them out, and instead of throwing them away, I just put it here. And it's kind of nice little art by some kid. Several different kinds of grass. This is not grass, but close enough. So there. I'll add some more. Something that is imaginary. A piece of styrofoam. I don't have that yet. Okay. Oop. Several plastic items of different colors. Well, I think they're different colors anyway, but this is different types of plastic. A discount card, another discount card. This is from, what is it, American Eagle. Something from a credit card. And same with this one. And then a sticker, which is plastic. And also a guitar pick. A Three Doors Down guitar pick. And I'll try to find more plastic things. Something curved. This is like a business card. I didn't really have anything else. Six triangles. I don't even know. Something with a hole in it. And this is a business card that was attached to something. Molds that I bought. This is a ticket. Like a from a can. This is a key which has a hole in it. And this is also a price tag. It has a hole in it here. And that was a sweater I recently bought from H&M. So, let's see here next. Part of a book. This is part of a book, this piece here. But I put wax on top of it because I was testing the wax. I got a wax, kind of a stamp. So, pencil rubbing of the bottom of a shoe. Okay, no, I don't have that yet. Something from a construction site. I don't have that yet. A UPC symbol. And the most recent one is probably this one. Because I bought something that was a lipstick in pale rose. And I'll show you that one later. But there's this other ones. And also a shipping label. So yeah, piece of green fabric. I don't have green. Some extra things. And then here I didn't really have many extra things. It kind of shows you. This was something that I glued on here for now because I did the run for the breast cancer run. And then it it tells you here which name to put down, but I was running for basically everyone, so I did it at my old job. Might do it again sometime. Let's see. And then there's a mystery object, which I don't have one yet. So I'm thinking what to add on my mystery object. I could put like an old photo, like a very, very old one. I don't know what else to add there. But yeah, that was my pocket scavenger. I did my best. I'm not done quite yet, but I should be done pretty soon. Let me know if you have one, and give this video a like and subscribe if you want to see more like this. Thank you. These are the three different, Okay, I have three different mascaras. They're all by the same brand. It's Essence. And this is the first one. This is the one I ran out of it recently, and it's really good. It hasn't given me any eye travel, eye problems, anything like that. This is the second one. This one's a volume boost, get big lashes. Ooh, I'm wearing one right now, but the one I'm wearing right now is this one, Rock and Roll. Also a volume eye-opening mascara. So, I'm going to be wearing the other two, and then I'll let you know which one was the best. Although, I'm pretty impressed with all three of them. They're all really good. The ones I wore by L'Oreal, I think. The ones I wore by that brand, it was making my eyes water out of random. Like, it would just start tearing up and it would just stream down my face. But what I noticed is this one, this blue one, is actually waterproof. So, it says smudge-proof, waterproof. I'm hoping that this one, because I have long lashes, it doesn't leave that black line up here. Because usually they do. My lashes are just long and they touch up here. So at the end of the day, it kind of like shows a little bit of smudging and stuff like that. So right now I'm wearing it. This is my real eyelashes. No fake lashes. And it's so far so good. Alright, till next time.